gentlemen, welcome to the Kings Island Firestone International Air Show. The air show you are about to see tonight will consist of three different parts. The second and third part of our show making a rich trial of handling a wonderful one by plane, AK and a Rich Barrett. Walking for what is an incredible aerobatic stuff flight to do. And as you can see in the middle there in our DC-3 subway, members of a Kings Island Firestone Championship Skydiving team. And that monster looks quite a bit different right now compared to what it's fully inflated. Our liftoff console stands up 60 feet high and 40 feet in diameter. Tonight, a hot air balloon is being piloted by a professional balloonist, Steve Adams from Senior, Ohio. Steve's good at work right now preparing his balloon for tonight's exciting flight. As you can see, our balloon crew is using a very powerful gas engine powered fan.
We were just released the pilot balloon a few minutes ago, and it went in the direction of the south parking lot, so we expect that to be our direction of flight as well.
Okay, very good. So you'll be flying right over the International Restaurant then. See how many flights do you have at Blue now?
Yeah, I've got right at 400 flights, John, and this is into my fourth season of flying loads. Actually, 3 years ago before flying season.
Otherwise, if I pop over to the other side here, we'd have to start this whole process all over again. Setting up very quickly now at full launch position. He's hopping inside the basket now. He's really going to be pointing into it now. During his flight, he can pull that rig cable and the top of the loop would fall out, and Steve Adams would come back down very quickly. Ladies and gentlemen, that will lift off Steve Adams and the Kings Island Firestone hot air balloon. Give him a warm send-off. A beautiful liftoff tonight here at Kings Island. Steve Adams, everybody, a beautiful liftoff. Oh, doesn't it sound like fun? Every night I wish I could join it, don't you? Yeah. A beautiful liftoff. As Steve begins to soar off into the distance, we'll continue with the second part of our show. Sydney Cup making the Richard Trader International Restaurant in the World War I biplane, side by side. Now, let's get back to it and watch how they take this plane into the first maneuver. Just a few feet off of each other, we're just getting airspeed right here. Watch how they take the bigger noses up. Bring them up now and straight up, watch what happens there. Straight up and over on their back, upside down, up and holding them in there, upside down, except one seat up, and down the other side. You can see those smoke trails they were pulling up. Beautiful inside precision loop. 8 King and a Red Bear and Harold Johnson, Steve Duncan. Beautiful hammerhead turns right there, laying the place over on the side. That's called a hammerhead turn or hammerhead saw. Now he's taking a lift there on a direct run away from each other, making some distance between themselves. And at the end of these runs, they'll once again do a hammerhead turns right there. And they use those turns to gain maximum air speed. 200 miles an hour as they come out of those turns. And that combined air speed of over 400 miles an hour. You'll notice that 8 King and a Red Bear will be on a direct collision course right at each other. Watch what happens at the time that they're bound to be here, an aerial game of chicken.
They're going to head after each other. They're playing chicken box.
The black turn here, heading right at the red turn, 400 miles per hour. The pioneers be really bearing down on each other. Watch what happens here. Right there, they're all twisting each other, but they're in a way of one moment, head on roll. 8 King and a Red Bear thrilling into each other. And the peak of the climb, a beautiful snap roll. A beautiful sample right next to Dom that looks like it has completely under control. As you can see, that's what you know, you can see that beautiful loop with a snap roll. It's now also known as a wedding ring because the snap roll resembles a wedding or a diamond at the top of a wedding band. That's Harold Johnson. A beautiful maneuver. It's my favorite, but it's also very, very dangerous. But not as dangerous as this next that barrel is also going to be performing. Coming from behind the Eiffel Tower, this is a tail fly. Many fine step out to be killed trying to stay stuck, you'll see why. Watch that plane now begin to slow down, slowing down, and hanging right there. Dead still, the lust is flying straight down backwards into the smoke. Nose over now, out of control. Nose down 220 miles an hour. Nose down, he needs to get control back on that plane. He got very low, he's right for the... Oh, he's waiting for the nose, there he gets, can you see him down here? Disappeared from my view.
Harold Johnson, we're going way below the tree line. We're going to take a beautiful tail fly.
Harold Johnson, everybody, a beautiful maneuver. And as I said, very dangerous.
Back upside down at three on the other side, pulling at each fourth position by four. Three
talking to speed talker. Ah, two of the finest pilots that you can see there, cruise control in the plane. And now, ladies and gentlemen, you'll notice that eighth thing is being pursued by the wind gun and the aero game. Here is simulation, here we are looking for them, and we will spend a little more one at a time fighting. AC's trying to get away from the wind, and bring his plane up on its back. It looks like it's loose. Nobody recovers from the top of that roof, and the half loop trying to flip the wind down. Trying to get away, and he'll pass everything he has up and trying to get away. Hey, for Red Bear time. What's the roof? Right there, there they are. Four jumpers going 120 miles an hour. Each jumper has a short canister attached to a group lead, watching through free ball. Falling right there at 20 miles an hour. Watch them join up together while falling. Watch that fourth jumper where he's laying there. Joining up right there, a beautiful strong formation. Four jumpers falling whatever at 20 miles an hour. Pushing hard like that. There's the bomber. They bring their arms into solid and increase their speed to 180 miles an hour. In world competition. Number four is Jackie Smith from London, England. She is the gold medal winner in world competition. Jackie Smith, keep an eye on her. Oh, watch out, Paul McCallum, actually, is up there trying to get beside the international wrestler. Going in very quick, but it's really reaching for it. I told him he's doing it, it's really reaching for it. Push down the line, beautiful line. Thank you.